Hello everyone, today I will explain the concept classful addressing. So every machine required a unique IP address. So that unique IP address, the whole address space is divided into 5 classes, that is class A, B, C and D, and that scheme is referred to as a classful addressing. So now if you observe the diagram for the address space in a classful addressing, for the class A, 50% space is reserved, for class B, 25%, class C, 12.5%, class D, that is 6.25%, and class C, E also 6.25%. So in class A, B, in a class A, address space is divided into four octets, that is 8 bits, and it is referred to as a zero prefix. It is referred to as a prefix and suffix. So in details we'll see each and every class. So now first, class A addresses. So class A IP addresses is the first octet is a network address, and the remaining 3 octets are the host address. The first bit of the first octet IP address is a zero, and the zero, and the lowest number can be represented using decimal zero and binary 000, and the highest number is the decimal 127, and it is represented using this form, that is 0111111. So 0 and 127s are reserved, so they cannot be used as a network address. So here we can start the IP address value between the 1 and 26. Example is 98.56.82.30. And next class is class B address. So class B address is a large size network. So here more than 65,000 host addresses are available. So in class B address, first 2 octets indicates the network address, and the remaining 2 octets provide the host address. So the first bit of the first octet of an address is always 1, and the second bit of first octet and of an IP address is always 0. So the first 2 bits are used to identify the class, and the next 14 bits is used to identify the host. So the lowest number of the class B is decimal 128, and the highest number is decimal 191. So any address for the class B, the value start with 128 and 199, the first octet of the class B address. Example is, you can write 167.3.27.30. Next class is class C address. So class C address is designed to support moderately large networks. So the maximum 254 host addresses are available. So it uses the first 3 octets to indicate the network address, and the remaining octet provides the host address. So the first 3 bits of addresses are 110 in the class C address. In class C address, the first 3 bits are identifies are the class identifier, and next 21 bits are the network address, and the last bits identify the host. The lowest number for the class C is decimal 192, and the highest number for the class C is decimal is 223. So any address can be start with the value 192 to 225 in the first octet is a class C address. The example is 92.168.0.1. Next is class D address. So class D address is designed to support the multicasting. So there is no need to allocate the octets to separate the network and host addresses. So the first bit of these addresses are 110. It's a multi-class address, and the lowest number that can be represented is decimal 224, and the highest decimal number is 239. So the any address that start with the value 224 and 239, the first octet of the class D. Example is 231.100.250.101. Then next is class E address. So class E address are reserved for the research purpose. So if the first 4 bit of the addresses are 111, it's a multicast address. The lowest number can be represented using decimal 240, and the highest number can be represented into the decimal 255. So any addresses, the value start between the 240 and 225 in the first octet, it is considered as a class C address. Thank you.